And the mechanism of Dienogest is a moderate inhibition of gonadotropin secretion, leading to modest reduction in the endogenous production of estradiol. Dienogest induces a hypoestrogenic, hypergestagenic local endocrine environment and causing decidualization of endometrial tissue followed by atrophy of the endometric lesions. Dual actions, maybe quadruple action, I will just tell you. First is at the level of the gonadotropin and it forms endogenous production of estrogen, is a modest reduction. Second is at the level of the endometrium, ectopic endometrium in the cells, forming a decidualization of the tissue, and therefore it reduces the plasma estrogen level. And third is direct inhibitory effect on the proliferation of endometrial-like tissue. So direct action, the peripheral is the direct local action is there. In addition to that, it has got an indirect anti-inflammatory activity through modification of pro-inflammatory markers. And the fourth is inhibition of angiogenesis. So earlier, the concept of hormone therapy is that it is forming on the either through the hypothalamic gonadotropin system, say for example GnRH analog, acts like that. It forms a hypoestrogenic environment and indirectly affects that. It has got a no local effect. But this is a drug. In addition to the central effect, it has a local effect on the decidualization of the tissue as well as anti-inflammatory action and the inhibition of angiogenesis. Lot of researchers are there on the pain in endometriosis. I remember Jan Frazer as a researcher on pain in endometriosis, how the pain is reflected. And at that level, how to relieve pain is a local drug which inhibits the angiogen, the anti-inflammatory reactions, could be able to reduce the pain. And a drug which have an anti-angiogenesis factor could abolish the total abolition of the disease and arrest the progress of the disease. That is the basic concept of that.